Principle number two, that the bearer of the Quran should understand. The Quran is the most pure, accurate, and undistorted. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikr wa inna lahu lahafizun. Indeed, it is we who sent down the Quran, and indeed we will be its guardian. Hadith number 2 of 40. Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu reports that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the most accurate and truthful speech is the Book of Allah. And as Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلَ. Who is more truthful in their speech and in their words than Allah Ta'ala? Who is more accurate? Every writing of every intellectual in history, it has been found that some of what they have said is true and some of what they have said is not true. It goes against scientific facts, historic facts, or other. And you will see with the Quran that whatever the Quran says about what we can see of this dunya and what we can visibly judge and investigate, that every fact that we come across, we will find that it is always in synchronization with what Allah Ta'ala says. And in fact, we will find that Allah Ta'ala has said what we ourselves are finding in modern scientific times, with scientific inquiry or with historical investigation or archaeological investigations and such like. The most truthful of speech, the most accurate of speech is the speech of Allah Ta'ala. And if what Allah Ta'ala speaks of this dunya is haq and true, then what Allah Ta'ala has spoken about what we cannot see of the afterlife is also true. And this gives the bearer of the Quran the confidence, the yaqeen, not only with regards to this dunya, but also with respect to the akhirah. Supplementary hadith A in this principle. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, while delivering a sermon one day, said that Allah Ta'ala said, I have sent you, O Nabi, I have sent you in order to put you to test and put those to test through you. This was a test. And I have sent you the book which cannot be washed away by water, so that you may recite it while in the state of sleep and being awake. Both. This is the amazing significance of the Quran, that the Quran was sent upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and by extension to us, that it be recited in our sleep and even when we are awake. Now, it is amazing, and this is something which can be looked upon by others who have seen this in certain teachers and ulama and those from Ahlul Quran, that there are some people who recite the Quran in an unconscious way, or in a way that, you know, the student is reciting the Quran and the teacher, an old sheikh, he's listening to the recitation of the Quran and he corrects the student while sleeping, and the student can hear the teacher snoring. Or we hear of people reciting the Quran in circumstances which are just beyond the conscious state of the individual. They're like in the semi-conscious or subconscious state. There are videos and such like of people in war zones where somebody is in a state being operated upon, or is in state between being awake and being asleep, but they're reciting the Quran fluently. And this just shows the deep impact that the Quran has on the conscious, semi-conscious and subconscious level of a human being. It goes down so deep beyond what you can even comprehend. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, how can you ask the people of the scriptures about their books while you have the book of Allah, which is the most recent of books revealed by Allah, and you read it in its pure, undistorted form? It is the Quran that has been preserved. No other book that was revealed to the previous prophets were preserved in its words like the Quran. Their remit of their prophets, of the prophets that were sent to the Jews or the Christian, like Isa alayhi salam or the previous Anbiya, their remit of their prophethood ended with those prophets, and whereas the Quran till the day of judgment.